Hello everyone and welcome to another video. The cheaper a ride, the easier it is to afford it and thus the more useful it is. This begs the question though, what is the cheapest ride design in the game? In this video we're going to take a look at what the cheapest rides are in a variety of categories and we will end with the cheapest ride in the entire game. The only rule here is that the ride has to function and be rideable, so no launched coasters that consist of only a single station piece that immediately crash upon testing. That rule isn't a problem for the first and most expensive category though, which is flat rides. With flat rides I mean any ride that you can just plop down and it's done, so no rides like mazes and observation towers because you can still edit those. The cheapest here is the Crooked House or any of its reskins at 260 euros. I don't find this very surprising as these rides are so simple that they cannot even break down. Next up is the cheapest stall. There isn't a lot of variety in building cost for shops and stalls and as a result the title of the cheapest is shared by all of these with a cost of just 200 euros. I would have expected the ATM to be cheaper than the souvenir stalls, but hey, what do I know? Now it gets a bit more interesting as we go for the cheapest roller coaster. The first thing that came to my mind was a tiny Wild Mouse coaster as it's a cheap coaster type and can do a very small loop of track with the tiny turns. The cheapest of the Wild Mouse coaster types is the Wooden Wild Mouse and a loop consisting of two station pieces, two straight pieces and four tiny turns costs exactly 200 euros. This is cheap, but it's not the cheapest coaster possible. There is an operating mode called Reverse Incline Launched Shuttle Mode, which is quite a mouthful. This is used on designs like the classic boomerang coaster and it will help us achieve great cheapness. Usually when you use this mode you build a chain lift going up from the back of the station and when the train reaches the end of the chain lift it releases and goes back down again. The thing is, you don't actually need to have a hill or even a chain lift. Whenever the train reaches the end of the chain lift or the track, whichever comes first, it will reverse. With this, we can construct the cheapest coaster design. We will use the looping coaster as that's the cheapest coaster type that has access to the reverse incline shuttle mode. First, we need a station piece and then we need one normal track piece behind it. This is because just a single station piece is too short for the shortest possible train, causing it to glitch and not work. Now all we need is one level to gentle piece in front of the station to cause it to reverse back into the station. And there it is. With 162 euros, this is the cheapest possible functioning roller coaster design. We can still go cheaper with other ride types though. It is now time for the cheapest transport ride. Once again, a tiny loop of track is cheap, but not the cheapest, this time thanks to shuttle mode. The miniature railway is the cheapest transport ride to build, so naturally it is also the perfect candidate for the cheapest transport ride design. All we need here is a station piece, a straight piece and another station piece. Just like with the coaster, the station is now too short for the train, but luckily we also have the trams available, which work perfectly fine. This amazingly useless transport ride only costs a nice 69 euros to build, making it over twice as cheap as the cheapest roller coaster. Even with less than 100 euros, this is not even close to the cheapest possible ride, as now we'll get into the realm of single tile rides. The first one is the cheapest water ride. There's not much to this, it's just a single station piece that costs us 44 euros. You do have to elevate either the queue line or the exit path as otherwise you block the guests off from the end of the station, but other than that this is about as simple as it gets. However, it's not as cheap as it gets. To find the key to unlock the secrets of maximum cheapness, we need to navigate the labyrinth of the maze. Or, in normal words, a maze that is just a single tile is the cheapest possible ride in the game. How cheap is it? Well, it's just 27 euros. If you thought that flat rides were cheap, then this is almost 10 times as cheap as the cheapest flat ride. If you maxed out the ride limit of 255 with just these tiny mazes, it would only cost you 6,885 euros, which is less than one decently sized roller coaster. It's actually not a bad idea to just build like 20 of these tiny mazes somewhere in a park. Each maze attracts 40 guests, so with 20 of those mazes you have just raised the soft guest cap of your park by 800 for under 1000 euros. Of course, you also need other rides to keep the guests in your park, but the mazes can help out a lot. And that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed our journey to the greatest cheapness ever achieved. If you did, you can give this video a like or leave a comment. You can also subscribe or follow me on Twitch. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video.